Hi, this is Bogdan from Romania, and tonight I'm going to share some tips and tricks from my quest for the perfect impression. First, obviously you need a smartphone, and you must disinfect it. Also, you need the instructions that come with the impression material. I know you find it funny, but the reason you need these two items is that the common mistake all dentists do while taking impression is that they don't keep enough time the impression material in the mouth. So, use the timer function on the mobile phone and also read the instructions that come with the material of choice you are using for your impression. Always do profound anesthesia for impression because there is no hypersalivation. For the maxilla, I use anesthesia between the upper premolar roots because I can numb the whole front of the maxilla. And for the mandible, I usually use either double speaks injection or double mental. My preference for impression material is not necessarily related to the material itself, but to the self-mixing machine. I like it because I don't have to trust a human to do it for me, and all I have to do is ask nicely my assistant to press the button. Even if in this case I will use a self-mixing machine, different cases need different types of impression. So you can also use a two-step impression, a one-step impression, two consistencies, one consistency, it really doesn't matter. Each case can be done with different techniques and different materials. It's absolutely important to understand what the retraction cord do. What it does is make a horizontal displacement of tissues, and that means that you don't have to press it too down the sulcus. It just needs to enter just to be flush of the sulcus, I like to say. It's very important to have a compact retraction cord because it will make the displacement easier. The technique to put the retraction cord inside that I use, and I have nice results with it, is that I like to push the retraction cord from side, like the spatula is between the teeth and the retraction cord. And it pushes and helps the retraction cord to slide in the sulcus, not to be pushed down below. After the first cord is in, you must inspect your retraction. If you cannot see more than 50% of your margin, you definitely have chosen the wrong side. So just take it out, don't be lazy, and put it again. Because even if you put the second cord in, you won't get that perfect impression. Trust me, I've been wrong so many times. If you put the cord inside and you can see more than 50%, you should proceed with the next step, that is putting the second cord. And I like to use what is called a selective double cord impression because you can put the second cord only where it's necessary to be put. I don't like to stress out the gingiva, and you must have in mind only one word while doing the insertion of the retraction cord. Be very gentle. If you are gentle and kinder to tissues, they will reward you staying at the same level where you did your preparation. This is key. You should take the second cord out of the sulcus very, 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 very slowly. As slower as you are, the more time the gingiva will stay displaced. I know it's not intuitive, and we all try to do it very quickly, like take the retraction cord, put the material inside, but it's much easier if you're doing it zen. I like to use a rigid impression tray because when I put the impression material in the mouth, I always do it in a vertical motion. You should do it too. It works. But the problem is that if you don't have a rigid tray, what will happen? When you try to pull it out, and I don't use the rocking motion, we were all used to it because it can deform the impression, I like to take it out in the same vertical motion as I placed it. And if you don't have a rigid tray, you will deform the tray, and actually with it, you will deform the impression. Deformation and distortion is the worst enemy during the impression. You want a rigid tray or you want a custom tray. You must inspect very well that impression because if you cannot see the margins, the lab won't see it either. I find that a good lab can make a very good restoration if they see the margins, even if the preparation is not perfect, but even the best lab in the world can do nothing if you had a bad impression and the best preparation. So make sure you inspect that impression good, and if you won't see, if there are spaces that you cannot see the margin, just redo it. It will make your life easier. I hope my practical tips will give you better impressions and also better restorations. I really hope that it will make you be a better dentist, it will make your life easier and will get you faster on the going stress-free wagon. I'm really glad you listened to this video, and until next time, bye-bye.